So here I am in the storyboard, and the first thing I want to do is add a button somewhere here in my app. The way to do this is to look in the utility area. In here at the bottom is this button called Show the Object Library. I'm going to click on it, and now I have access to a whole bunch of different user interface elements. Things like a button, a slider, and many others. Now, I can look at them in this list format, or I can click on this little button here and see the icon view. There it is. I can even search for things I want, like a button in this case, and there's the element I want. So I'm going to drag this button onto the editor and use these blue lines as a guide for dropping it into the center of the canvas. There. I can change the text of this button to, let's say, record. I can also change the width and the height of this button. There. Now, one good practice here is to go to the editor menu at the top and click on Size to Fit Content. This way, the button will automatically change its size as you type in it. There. Let me drag this in the center one more time. Done. Now, once you've selected the button, I want you to click on this tiny little icon here, which is called the Attributes Inspector. If you click on it, it will present to you a whole bunch of different options that can help you change the attributes of the button. You can change the text here, the font here, and a whole bunch of different options that we will tinker with soon. All right, so for now what I want to do is I want to run my app and see if this button even shows up on the app. The way to do this is to use something called a simulator, which is our way to run the app without needing a hardware device. At the top here, you will notice a list of simulators that are available. I'm going to use iPhone 5S, and that's because this simulator fits really well on my recording screen. You could have used iPhone 6 or iPhone 6 Plus for that matter. Then I'm going to click on this play button to run the app. Notice that the simulator may take a while to load up when you run it for the first time. All right, so there's our simulator, and there's the button inside the simulator. Although it's not quite in the center yet, and that is somewhat bothersome, but I will fix that in the next video. For now, I can click on it, and nothing happens because we haven't programmed the button to do anything just yet. As a quick aside, you can go to the window menu here at the top and change the scale to make sure that the phone fits really well on your computer screen. This is a little bit too big for me, so I'm going to keep the scale at 50%. There. Also, if you go to the hardware menu at the top, you can rotate your phone left, you can rotate it right, and you can go to the home screen. There's our app, pitch perfect. All right, so the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to fix this button so it shows up in the center of the phone.